Good morning. Welcome to Holy Family Parish. Please stand for our opening hymn, found in the Green Catholic Book of Worship, number 392, That Easter Day with Joy Was Bright. CBW 392, please join us in singing.
Sunday Eucharistic celebration on this third Sunday of Easter. We also welcome all those who are joining us online. The first important thing we do now is to invite all the nice children for Children's Church to come forward so that we can send them forth. Children, all the good children of our parish, for Children's Church, for this Mass, to come forward now. Good, 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 good children. Good, good children. Yes. Yes. Very good. Thank you for coming. And so the Children's Church is where we go to learn something about Jesus, about God, about the church. And so, as always, I'll tell you to listen attentively so that you learn something when you get home, you can tell your family what you heard at the Children's Church. So we are now send you out the blessing of the mighty God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and your teachers, now and forever. Amen. Okay, follow your teachers now, please. As the children go to their place of learning, we now turn around and pick our prayer friend for this Mass. The person you are going to pray for during the universal prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Sisters and brothers, while Jesus was alive here on earth, he promised, wherever two or three are gathered in his name, there he will be in their midst. And Jesus, of course, doesn't promise and fail. Straight after his resurrection, he started appearing to his disciples and apostles wherever they were gathered, as we see in the gospel of today. And so each time we gather like this to do what Jesus has asked us to do, Jesus is here with us in our midst. And so when we pray with faith. All that he requires of us is to try to repent, to try to endeavor not to commit sins, so that whenever we beckon on him, he will answer our prayers. So we pray at this Mass that Jesus, who knows how to be with his disciples, will remain with us all the time. It is Easter, and so we are going to sprinkle water on ourselves now in place of the penitential rite.
Springs of water, bless the Lord, give him glory and praise forever. Alleluia. Give him glory and praise. Springs of water, bless the Lord. Give him glory and praise forever. Alleluia. Give him glory and praise. Springs of creation, river and ocean, roar out your praises to God on high. Sing forever, alleluia. Let your water sound in praise. Springs of water, bless the Lord. Give him glory and praise forever, alleluia. Give him glory. Springs in the wilderness, up from the barren ground, cry out your praises to God on high. Sing forever, alleluia, let your water sound in praise. Springs of water, bless the Lord, give him glory and praise forever. Alleluia, give him glory and praise. Springs of the Jordan, waters of Galilee, sing out your praises to God on high. Sing forever, alleluia, let your water sound in praise. Springs of water, bless the Lord. Give him glory and praise forever. Alleluia. Give him glory and praise.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace is stronger.
May your people exalt forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that, rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. At the temple gate, Peter addressed the people. The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and rejected in the presence of Pilate, though he had decided to release him. But you rejected the holy and righteous one and asked to have a murderer given to you. And you killed the author of life, whom God raised from the dead. To this we are witnesses. And now, brothers and sisters, I know that you acted in ignorance, as did also your rulers. In this way, God fulfilled what he had foretold through all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and turn to God, so that your sins may be wiped out. The word of the Lord.
Please join us in the response.
Let the light of your face shine on us, O Lord. Let the light of your face shine on us, O Lord.
Answer me when I call, O God of my right. You gave me room when I was in distress. Be gracious to me and hear my prayer. Let the light of your face shine on us, O Lord. But know that the Lord has set apart the faithful for himself. The Lord hears when I call to him. Let the light of your face shine on us, O Lord. There are many who say, oh, that we might see some good. Let the light of your face shine on us, O Lord. Let the light of your face shine on us, O Lord. I will both lie down and sleep in peace, for you alone, O Lord, make me lie down in safety. Let the light of your face shine on us, O
reading from the first letter of St. John. My little children, I am writing these things to you so that you may not sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the atoning sacrifice for our sins, and not only for ours, but also for the sins of the whole world. Now by this, we may be sure that we know him, if we obey his commandments. Whoever says, I have come to know him, but does not obey his commandments, is a liar, and in such a person, the truth does not exist. But whoever obeys his word, truly in this person, the love of God has reached perfection. By this, we may be sure that we are in him. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Jesus, open the scriptures to us. Make our hearts burn with love when you speak.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The two disciples told the 11 and their companions what had happened on their road to Emmaus and how Jesus had been made known to them in the breaking of the bread. While they were talking about this, Jesus himself stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." They were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. He said to them, "Why are you frightened? And why do doubts arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet. See that it is I myself. Touch me and see, for a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you see that I have." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While in their joy they were disbelieving and still wondering, he said to them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate it in their presence. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus it is written, that the Christ is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord. First, I want to thank those who brought forward gifts for babies and for moms. The CWL is collecting these things for the Limberlost community, not as part of our community, our parish, who have a special need, so thank you for your generosity. You can bring it any time, we'll make sure that they get them. So, Easter season. We keep talking about the resurrected Lord for 50 days. 50 days and 50 nights. And why do you think that we do that? Because, I don't know about you, but sometimes I forget things that are important that should never happen, but I sometimes just forget. And so sometimes you have to hear it over and over and over again. And then we begin to see, aha, that's what it means. So it's important for us to hear beautiful gospels like this, when Jesus, who suffered and died and rose again, that we get a bit of an understanding about what it was like for Jesus' resurrected body. Because after his death, he didn't turn into ashes. And we heard that he wasn't a ghost. But he was a resurrected body that had fleshiness. He showed the signs of where he suffered. But the signs of where he suffered don't hurt anymore. So part of the resurrected body is no more suffering. It's behind us. Another great thing that we hear about a quality of the resurrected body is that Jesus asked for something to eat. I'm so glad that in the resurrected body we'll have food to eat when we get to heaven. So we hear these scripture stories about Jesus because he is telling us one day, hopefully for you as well. But there were no automatic tickets. You know, there is no way, unless anyone discovered a back staircase into heaven. Has anyone discovered a back staircase into heaven? I have not heard of it. So it can't really be presumed. You can't presume that at the moment that you die, that you're going to be taken into heaven. I mean, that's not what Jesus says. So it is important that we hear what Jesus did teach. That's why when we hear Jesus in the gospel, he's reminding his disciples, yes, all these things that are taking place now, the prophets and the law and all of the Psalms, they talk about this. And so Jesus kind of puts all of it together and it makes sense for them. And we need to make it sense for ourselves as well. So we need that in our own lives. During this season of Easter, we're also going to every week be talking about a little bit of our vision of becoming one day in the best of a reality. One day, wouldn't it be exciting and fantastic that each one of us here fell in love with Jesus so much that we would tell all of our friends, and all of our friends would come here with your friends, and then we would have to add a couple extra more masses? That, I think, would be fantastic. Don't you think that would be something we should look forward to? You think that's possible? Yes. It is. Well, the only way it's going to be possible is up to you. Not me. Not Father Jude. It's up to you. When we meet Jesus, the resurrected Christ, and we know with all our hearts and minds that we want others to experience the same. That's why parents love to have their children baptized when they're infants, and they grow them as Christian daughters and sons right from a very young age. So one of the things each week, the next 5 weeks, we're going to be talking about one of our core values. Last week we talked about warm-hearted. When you see a need, you respond to it with compassion. You reach out to someone and support them and love them. This week we're going to be talking about the core value of repentance. What does it mean to be in good relationship with each other? And we know in our families, our own lives, that if we're not in a good relationship with people, there's just something that's missing. There's something that gnaws at us when things are not quite, I think, as the Lord desires for us. So one of the things we're going to teach you today is to put all of those pieces of kind of salvation history together in a couple little frames, a little diagrams, so it makes clear. So I'm going to invite us to look at the first screen right now. So God and humanity had a beautiful unity with one another. God talked to humans, humans talked to God. It was a love fest all the time. Now, when was that true in the history of mankind? When did that take place? In paradise, Garden of Eden, right? They loved each other. They were completely happy with God, what had to offer them abundance of life. But then something happened. Adam and Eve decided that in their life, they knew a little bit better than God. And so there was a fracture in the relationship between God and humanity. And that's what we see in the next slide. There was a fracture in the relationship between heaven and earth, God and humanity. And how was that going to be fixed? Through a Tower of Babel, kind of building up ourselves, anything that we can possibly do that we can get ourselves to heaven? It doesn't work that way. It could only happen if God made that happen in a perfect blend of humanity and divinity. God became one of us in the person of Jesus. So he is the only one that could heal that fracture, the only one of all of human history. And so through his love being poured out for us, an everlasting love, he died for us. He died for our sins, offered us the gift of forgiveness and peace. And so that is the next slide that we have. He's the bridge. Jesus is the only bridge that we have between earth and heaven. There isn't any other way. He is it, IT. So then what is the guarantee then that we can cooperate with the Lord at the moment of our death and live with him? Or as a matter of fact, how can we taste pieces of heaven here on earth? And we know what that is, don't we? We know what that is. That is when we get to know Jesus and we have a deep relationship with him. And this is where we have the next little picture here. The bridge, he destroys separation, he destroys sin, he destroys death. And the next slide is that the bottom section, the first one talks about where is faith, where is love in my life? And sometimes it can be outside of my life, sometimes a part of my life, and or the center of my life. But in this, the next row, what we have is that for a lot of people, faith and Jesus is somewhere in the world, somewhere exists somewhere, but not what you would call effective at all. Not effective at all in their life. And then the next little picture there says, well, yeah, Jesus is kind of part of my life, and that's kind of nice. So I like Jesus in my life when I need him. When I don't need him, then I can do whatever I want. But there's no guarantee in that either. The only guarantee is that when Christ is at the center of our lives, then everything that he promises we know from our hearts, from our lives, giving our lives in self-giving love to the Lord and to others who need the Lord's love in our lives. So right relationship is all about that, all about that. And sometimes we don't even realize that we may not be needing some healing in our relationships. And so we're going to hear from one of our wonderful parishioners, one of her stories about right relationships in her own life. And then I'll make a couple comments after that. So let us have that video right now.
I'm Barbara Milanovic, and I've been a parishioner here at Holy Family for about 36 years. Learning about those values has helped me to focus my faith journey. I participated in many different programs through the years, and I think they're all of value. I think that the Lighthouse helps to bring a lot of it together in a way that is accessible, a way that's understandable, and a way that can change how you feel about God, how you feel about your community, how you feel about your faith. I think that, you know, you have to look at your closest relationships first. And one of the closest you can have is between a mother and child. And it came to my attention just not long ago, within the last 5 years, that there was a lot of tension between myself and my daughter, because I had expectations that weren't realistic, and that I wanted her to follow through on things that I thought were important. Not understanding her own needs, her own independence, and all the things that were important to her. I caused a lot of pain. I caused a lot of pain in her. Yet I was blind to it. I didn't understand that it was me who was exacerbating the pain, who was making the relationship tense, who, you know, was leading us down this path of distance, really. Until one day I was taking part in a retreat, and it was during COVID, so it was online. I was journaling, and I can only say that it must have been the Holy Spirit that triggered me to suddenly understand that it was me. It was me that was doing wrong. It was me who was creating dissension and problems and causing a lot of pain. And that's the last thing that a mother wants to recognize. It's painful to recognize that, oh no, you've been wrong all along, and that you have been doing this to the child that you love, that you say you love. And so I have to say that was a turning point. I was completely broken down by it. I called her immediately to apologize, to let her know that things were going to change, that I understood my part in it, and that it wasn't going to continue. When I hear other people's faith stories, when I hear them talking about their difficulties and their challenges and how they overcame them and how they've been comforted and how they've been strengthened by the love of God, that helps me on my faith journey. And I hope that by my own sharing of my own trials and some of my successes then, because I've reached out to God, that I can help others too. So it's a very mutual thing. It's all of us together as the body of Christ. It's not just one of us or a few of us. It's all of us coming together and helping each other. The first word that comes to my mind really is gratitude. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for being with me every day, even when I don't recognize that you are, that you're there for me at all times. And no matter how many times I fail, that I can come back and that I can trust that you will be there for me and for our community, and to help me through times of trial.
Actually, Barb, many of you may know Barb. She's a wonderful parishioner here at Holy Family. And one of the things that struck me is that she knew that there was some tension in the relationship between her and her daughter, but she didn't know what the source of it was nor how to get through it. And was in praying, being open to where the Lord was going to break through with God's love and mercy that she recognized that. And I think that can be true in many of our relationships. There's not something quite right, but we need a way forward for healing and for peace. And the Lord's mercy and healing is always available for us and helps us to navigate the most significant relationships that we have. It's fantastic. So that's part of how the resurrected Christ is present to us in our day. Loving us, encouraging us, speaking clearly in our minds and our hearts to see what it is that needs to be dealt with in our lives, and to lead us gently with love and mercy and power. So we continue during this Easter season to ponder with lively stories of faith how people are coming to know, with Jesus at the center of their lives, what impact that has for them and hopefully for us.
Let us rise to profess our faith. I believe in God, trust and confidence. Now let us bring before God our needs and the needs of others.
For church leaders and all Christians to bear witness to the resurrection of Jesus by the joy and hope they radiate, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of governments to intensify their efforts to restore peace to all the troubled spots of the world today, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who will be receiving the sacraments of First Holy Communion and Confirmation during these Easter weeks to be spiritually strengthened, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For young people to consider vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the members of our family of parishes to bear such witness as to bring others to the joy and peace of the gospel, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are in need of healing and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, including Monique McGregor, sister of Yolande Weeks, Janet Greer, mother of our office administrator, Kelly Wilson, Father Andrew Sipek, Teresa Agnes Bedard, mother of Father Gerard Bedard, Herman Van Meerbergen, uncle of Lisa Wright, Ronald LeBlanc, uncle of Michelle DeVos. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our private intentions now. And don't forget that this is a time you also remember to pray for that prayer friend you picked up at the beginning of this Mass. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Heavenly Father, we praise and thank you for bringing us together as a family of parishes
called to be a light for the world. We thank you for giving us a vision to become an invitation, our community of disciple-making disciples who have Jesus at the center of everything we believe, say, and do. May we rely on the Holy Spirit to inspire us to love the Scriptures, to share our faith stories, to foster right relationships, and to be warm-hearted. We entrust our family of parishes to the care of our Blessed Mother and Saint Joseph, the Holy Family, and Saint Patrick, as we work together to bear witness to our core values and to become the people you desire us to become. We ask this in the name of Jesus, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
Catholic Book of Worship, number 405, Sing of One Who Walks Beside Us, CBW 405.
Sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, And as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb, who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Ronald Peter our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that to the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. The risen Lord who is always present to his people and comes to them in their need. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word.
Gather number 593, I myself am the bread of life. I myself am the bread of life. Catholic Book of Worship, number 397, this joyful Eastertide, CBW 397.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those who we are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We have a few announcements. The first one is to remind us that our prayer ministry group already gathering there under the Holy Family statue to pray with anyone who steps forward asking for prayers for themselves or for other people. Now, a new study, the Chosen Scripture Study, asking, join us this spring as we watch season one of The Chosen and discuss the life of Jesus through Scripture. This will hold on Thursdays starting April 18th and will end by June 6th from 3 p.m. to 5 p.m. You have to register online. We are lighthouse.ca/chosen. In support, Father Bob has already said something about this. In support of the CWL convention this month, each council is asked to select a charity to take up a donation for and present to them. Holy Family CWL has chosen to support the London Community Chaplaincy, Limbalost. This weekend, April 13 and 14, that's today, we are collecting new brand name feminine pads and baby wipes for their supply to help those in need in our area. Finally, we are reminded to pick up a copy of the Easter Beacon and Family Connection in the Narthex. Thanks, everyone. Thanks to all those who helped us to make sure things run smoothly at this Mass. The sacristan, the hospitality team, those helping us with the overhead live stream. Thanks to the children who went for the children's church and their teachers. Thanks to all the children at this Mass. We ask God to bless you, parents, for making it possible for children and young people to come to church. Thanks to our readers at this Mass. Thanks to all those who helped us to distribute Holy Communion. Thanks to our altar servers. Thanks to the choir leading us in the singing. If you're happy with all these people, put your hands together for them. Okay, sisters and brothers, let us now bow our heads for the blessing. The response to each is Amen. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing.
Amen.
May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in the right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon all of you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Let us go in peace, spreading the good news of the Lord.
Thanks.
Catholic Book of Worship, number 386. Good Christians all, rejoice and sing. CBW 386, please join us in singing.